Okay. I am just curious about all this stuff because I'm looking here at what I'm shit looking like, and I am just still. So anyway, I'm gonna try a couple other things. I'm checking this out. It'd be kind of nice to be able to see myself. I don't know how to do that, so I'm learning about this video business with Facebook. I never tried this before. Anyway, hey, good to see everybody coming in. Wow. Now I can't see me moving, so hopefully I'm moving here, you know. Holy crap. I really didn't know what I was going to talk about. I just thought I'd try this. And can you see this? The Shaka? Yeah. Yeah, okay. I guess it just shows up later. So anyway, nothing in particular I want to talk about, although there is a lot going on. I just want to try this and welcome everybody. And I have no idea this was going to come up, but we're just kind of taking a test of the live streaming thing here with Facebook. And I'm looking at the screen and I can't see anybody, anything, except I can see the comments. So, anyway, I'm probably just gonna end this after about a couple minutes, but there's it feels pretty good today. It feels pretty clear today. A lot of things I think are clarifying, and I don't really know what's there's been a lot coming out again, continuing to come out, and I don't know, the news. There's all sorts of news. Hey, Donald. Aloha. And we're just kind of in the middle of waiting for tomorrow. Tomorrow is kind of a big day because for here it gets very loud towards the end of the day. So about this time tomorrow, it's going to be active outside. So anyway, we're just kind of like we're kind of like hanging out here for a minute with my blue background. And so there's no particular news. Hey, Marcelo. We are saying just, I must say, I think there's one thing that I'm noticing right now is that there seems to be kind of a clarity, what's going on, a lot of clarification. My shoulder is feeling quite a bit better. And hey, Barbara. Oh, aloha. There we go. And that's kind of new to me, so I just thought I'd say it's kind of fun. I'm seeing all these things go down at the bottom, little likes and smiles and stuff like that. And hey, Patty and Maggie, and who did I miss? Donald and Stephen, and Stephen, two Stephens, Alexi and Stephen Mignon. Great to see you. Yeah, we're just kind of, I feel like this is kind of an interesting time right before the official calendar, Julian calendar, New Year's, it'll start to take place, and we're kind of like just enjoying the. I do feel that there's a lot going to be happening this coming year. A lot is being closed out right now, and all this and all that stuff I could say probably better on a radio show. And I have the thing about this video is that I'm not sure how to make it so I can actually see myself, but I can't see what I'm doing. I'm just sitting there with my little necklace on. That's a Sintamani stone, by the way. This is Sintamani. It was the personal stone out of the many that was that were sent to that I purchased a few, and then a few were sent to me by one of Cobra's co-workers, and they went on the mission to all throughout all the islands. And this was the one I knew right away as I saw the group of them that this was this longer one sort of matches the long body, but it was definitely the personal one. So hey, aloha, Tara. Oh, Josh, good to see you. Josh, you down there in are you down well, as we say up here, down under. You over in Australia? I forget. Not that I need to know. But anyway, I'm just kind of sitting here. Well, what the heck am I doing here? I'm just trying something out. So it's pretty neat. You can do these lot. Yes, Australia. Okay, good. Well, I got a couple friends of mine who are on the, I think they're in the in Sydney area, and they are, I am fine. They are getting married. It's a couple, a male couple, two males. They're getting married because I understand that Australia just approved the marriage of same-sex couples. So that's great. And I think it's sometime in February that they're going to do this. So how's the Hawaiian independence coming? Well, it's, you know, it's sort of going in phases. I think there's supposed to be a big celebration, a big meeting coming up in on January 17th. I believe it's the 17th they're going to have it of this coming year. And that's the 125th anniversary of the what is called the overthrow, although technically it really never was an overthrow. There never was any legal overthrow or any kind of official. There was certainly no official, truly legal annexation of the islands of the Hawaiian Kingdom by any part of the United States. So one thing at a time. You know, one thing at a time. And thank you for praying for that. I do feel it is going to happen. And believe it or not, I really believe Donald Trump, this whole thing with Trump, the Trump effect, is one step in bringing the entire United States operation back into the actual Republic of the United States. And so a lot of these things, I sense that a lot of these things are going to be eventually addressed and corrected. So that's my sense about it. And I know that many who are connected with Hawaii, especially like Barbara, she's connected very strongly. And I'm not as active in that as I used to be, but I do know that there's several people who are going over, pardon me, as I drool. But they're, one of the things that they're emphasizing now is that there's no point in arguing about things with other people. You know, you can sort of, you know, get your fist up and just saying, well, the Hawaiian Kingdom still exists and all this. But it seems like it's turned to more now, more of a communication and trying to talk with people. Let's see. Okay, Josh wrote me a question. AKP, what would you like to see happen for humanity in 2018? Or if you will, what do you see happening for 2018? Oh my goodness. Well, I'll tell you. You know, I can tell you the one thing, there's going to be a lot of explosions that are kind of little explosions popping out. I'm seeing little explosions now. Speaking of first of the new year. And by the way, for those of you who don't know here, the first of the year is midnight, tomorrow night. It's traditional that everybody and their grandmothers, great-grandparents, grandchildren, unborn children, they all get fireworks, and they all light off fireworks all at the same time. And I think they can do it they can start officially about 10 p.m., but the big explosions start about midnight, and they can go up until maybe about 1 or 2 in the morning. So, I do feel, Josh, that there's a lot of, there's going to be a lot of small bursts of awakenings and a burst of things coming out. Of course, we've got all the sex stuff. You know, the people have been playing around, and now they're finding out that they've been playing around in a variety of ways. But I like what some of the other videos have talked about, and I think the Liz Croken video I posted yesterday, they have a lot of, she's pointing out that these things, if they were to come out all at once, would really freak people out so much that it's possible that they wouldn't be able to accept it all. So by leaking it out a little bit at a time, I can see the value of that. So, but I really see there's such a great freeing of many parts of humanity all around the world. And one step at a time, as the United States as a whole takes back its sovereignty over itself, sovereignty within itself, and within, you know, really, you know, for the best thing that I think happens to all of us is that we learn to take care of our own inner challenges and to stop trying to fix everybody else outside of ourselves, and we start to address what's going on within. And for me, that's kind of what's been happening since last year ago, November, that now it's starting to gradually, we're starting to move away, move out of these other countries and stop being the military industrial complex that President Eisenhower warned us about. And so thanks for that question, Josh. I don't know anything specific things that I can see happening, but I think for me, the best thing to do is to continue sending love and white light or healing to all these people who are going through this stuff. I mean, they all came in to play a certain role, and that even includes, you know, people like John McCain and Hillary Clinton and Bill Clinton, and but all of these folks are playing a role to help get us awakened, help us wake up, and help us to say, hey, let's start doing something, let's start exposing this, let's start sharing this. And so I'm talking like I know what I'm talking about, and in the end I really don't, but one thing at a time, I can see that things really are going to be a lot brighter this coming year. So yes, all the world's a stage. So we just got Fern, Pedro, and Christopher, and thank you all for joining. I didn't expect this would be lasting this long. This was just kind of a trial run, and I have no idea what I look like. All I can see is a picture of me sitting there, and yeah, it's all part of the plan. Patience. So, Arjuna, aloha, aloha to Maui. Arjuna is a wonderful being, a capital B-E and a capital I-N-G, a being who lives on Maui. And every time I go to SipMe, S-I-P-M-E, coffee shop in Makawao, almost every time Arjuna is there. So that's kind of how we meet up. So, well, while we're here, anybody else have any more questions or things you want to talk about? I'm just kind of looking at the list here. Let's see, what else could we talk about? Let's see. It just turned dark over here. We had a beautiful sunset. See, Barbara says I look like a handsome brother with my tan. Oh. Yeah, that always kind of looks like, well, it's kind of natural. This is sort of my natural look. Not everybody doesn't wear a shirt, but I most all the time don't wear a shirt. To me, it's, of course, I know there's a lot of benefits from being in the sun and having the sun shine on your skin. And it's kind of like, when I go to the U.S. or something like that in the winter, and people see me, and it's kind of like, oh, wow, it's like, where'd you get that tan? You know, it's like, well, it's not that much of a tan compared to some people, but I do feel that we're really, you know, it's just a wonderful time to be here. And I know that some people are really still probably, I know some people that are very close to me, and I love them dearly, you know, they're still a little bit triggered by kind of some of the things that are happening with what you might call the Democrat Party, the liberal media, things like that. Yes, things are happening, but again, I also see a lot of things, some things from time to time that are actually coming out on those media outlets. And so at one point, I feel in 2018, I don't feel like the mainstream media is going to disappear, but I feel like so many of the people that are in that mainstream media, the ones that are in that are waking up. And so they're starting to expose things, and they're starting to not necessarily go along with all the, you know, with all the mainstream, you know, they're reading from a card kind of a deal. So and if I'm pixelated, that just means that, you know, every so often, I guess I go off in another dimension. So we're multidimensional beings. And I will say one thing. I love all of you. I send aloha to all of you. And I know that I don't really realize how many people we connect with, or that connects through the KP blog or through Facebook. I really don't have any idea, but I'm just so grateful for everyone being here. So and for following what I put out there. And you know, there's so many people who are just putting it out there right now. And I'm glad that there's other people like Jordan Sather and now Roy Potter, some of these other folks who are just putting these things out about the actual day-to-day events. And yeah, it's just, there is the Lush effect, Christopher. Well, thank you, Maggie. Yes, appreciate you too. And aloha, Ruben. I'm not sure how you say your last name, but it looks like Ruben Llinas, L-L-I-N-A-S, Llinas. That's how I'd say it in a Spanish way. But what are my thoughts on Cobra, says Josh. Josh, the one who is a saint. Yeah, the last interview is pretty cool. Well, I'll just sort of put this out a little bit, that as I understand, I'm going to be included in a group of, I think, three people. Luisa of Goldfish Report is putting this together. Another interview, kind of a group discussion. And I'm really grateful for her because she's gotten good at this putting people together thing. So, yeah, so hopefully we'll be on another one in the next couple months. And I really enjoy talking with Cobra and the people who are on there. And it's kind of nice to hear his voice that's not, when it's not not modulated, you know. So he's a pretty neat guy. And I feel like each person has sort of grabbed their space or taken their space and is honoring their space. And the fact that he still wants to modulate his voice is perfectly okay with me. It's just we each have our own way of connecting and our own mission as we go along this path. So I am pretty amazed what happened, though, after, you know, speaking of Cobra. And this was a necklace I was wearing during the entire solstice mission when I went to Kauai. And it was so astounding to come back after that was done and to see all these things that were popping out. There was this executive order thing, and there's another one that just came out. Apparently there's declaring the month of January 2018, something about human trafficking and about freedom from that. And Jordan Sather was just on a video, just did a video. I just watched a part of that video, and he said that actually Obama, and maybe other presidents, but I think Obama for several years also put out the same thing. And it could very well be that Barack Obama was so compromised that he had to put out what was written for him. But Jordan was pointing out that there's several aspects of this newer one that really appeared to have a lot more depth to it and a lot more meat in it. So, you know, we've seen all these things going on, and I feel like a lot of things are being cleaned up. And so By the way, what time is it over there, Josh? What time is it over there in Australia? And what part of Australia? Are you on the west side or the east side? I'll just throw that out. So if you want to, it's 6:19 p.m. here in Hawaii, and I think Japan is like, if I subtract 4 hours, it'd be five, and add a day, it'd be like five, it'd be like 2 o'clock in Tokyo. Not that that's important, but we're all kind of on the same time frame whenever we get together with these things, and time's an illusion anyway. So okay, 219, Queensland. Okay. So thank you all for coming out. I guess to be honest with you, 11:20 in Jersey, good. It's not too super late. I think it's just kind of neat. I said, I never knew I could do this. So I'll have to see how it works, because I a lot of times I'll make a video and it's nice to have the video and save the video. So, and yes, okay, well, we'll get to that next time. I think I'm gonna call an end to this one, but I sure appreciate everyone coming in, and we'll continue the great work. Everybody out there, continue the great work and sharing and all that. So with that, I'm going to say aloha to all, and a hui ho, which means until we meet again, until we talk again. Aloha.